Yeah, I just got out of Hubbard's Military Supply, and I gotta say, I love that place. It's so awesome. Yeah, I actually decided to go against getting a new AK. I'm probably gonna get one by the end of the summer. And I decided this because I thought, you know, with my 30-06, it didn't make any sense getting another rifle when I didn't have enough ammunition for the rifles that I already had. I had plenty of ammunition for the AK, plenty of ammunition for pretty much all my guns, except for the 22 and the 30-06. So I just only had like one box, so it didn't make any sense to buy a new AK when I needed like another box of that. Plus, I didn't have any type of walkie-talkies. One thing I gotta say about this walkie-talkie is that it has a NOAA type of system where I can get access to emergency channels, which is pretty important. There's an emergency situation and power isn't reliable and phones aren't reliable. And I also like the idea, it says a 20-mile range, but realistically it's probably going to be like a mile or two within the city, because there's more physical barriers preventing you from actually getting that signal through. I've been asking questions about Benadine. And, you know, the good thing about this stuff is they actually use this in hospitals, and you can use this for cuts and burns, and this is supposed to be really good at keeping out the germs and really preventing infection. And you can never have too many batteries. And I love this flashlight so much, I actually got another one because, you know, it's pretty bright. And, you know, the energy seems to last a while. Speaking of lights, I came across these glow sticks. they're really interesting. You know, you press it, it's like a little mini flashlight. Not a big deal, but press it again, and there you go, it glows, right? Again. Again. So that's really interesting. I actually purchased two of them. What else is going on? Oh, it's also good to have literature, you know. you don't want to just be bored if something does happen. You want to stock up on as many books as you can. And I don't mean your Kindle, because if it's an electronic, you may not be able to rely on it. I'm finding this out myself. Interesting thing is, my computer actually went dead. The power supply wouldn't work. This happened about a couple weeks ago. I really panicked because I tried to turn it on, and that button right there just started to blink. I mean, started to flash, right? And nothing happened. So I went online, I looked it up, and it turns out if you use a blow dryer, I use a blow dryer and I actually blew it into this area, and you can actually get it restarted. Well, nothing happened. I tried it a couple times. Then I plugged it back in. Then I blew it, and sure enough, I actually got it to come on. And now I'm able to log off, turn off my computer, then turn it back on. I actually disconnected the cable, and I replugged it back up, and it's still working. So it's sort of a interesting concept. You don't want to overdo it, and I'm not a technician or anything, but it's just something I wanted to mention. Anyway, going back to the preps, water. Yeah, this is pretty good for making the water biologically safe. There's a lot of products out there, like the straws and stuff, that filter out certain debris and certain things, but they're not necessarily designed to filter out the dangerous bacteria. So that's something you have to really look at. You have to take a look at what you're getting. Also, when you buy this type of stuff, there's something else I bought. Oh, before I move on, the top one actually makes it cleaner, the white one, and I think the yellow one actually removes a bad taste. Actually makes it taste a lot better. Okay, the cool thing about this product is that not only does it have an all hazards NOAA radio, a weather radio capability, but it also has rechargeable batteries that are actually included in it. So I'm going to open this up in another video and actually test this thing out and actually test the range to see how far I can actually go with this thing. Oh, so question of the day, what type of preparations are you making in terms of communication, and how high of a priority is this for you? Yeah, I definitely want to be able to communicate with people on my block, so I can figure out what's going on and what's coming into my direction. And this is a good thing to have for storms or anything in general, you know. Prepping isn't just about, you know, economic collapse. It could be a hurricane, whatever. Just common sense. Okay, a little update on my garden. First of all, I'm so glad I didn't plant anything, because we actually have a frost going on right now. The weather was so nice here in Michigan, but then we had this frost, and I'm so glad I didn't put anything into the ground. I actually pulled out a lot of roots in this area, but I spoke with this guy, he's a neighbor. He fought in World War II, and he's been planting a garden. He actually has a little spot where I can actually plant food. So I'm not going to show it here, but it's within the neighborhood, and I'm pretty excited about this. So my project is probably going to be on that property, and not on my property yet. Yeah, he has a tiller and everything, so that's going to be pretty cool. Alright guys, so this is what I've been doing with my preps. Thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.